Good morning, my dear students. Again, I am going to solve that is continuation of the last class problem. That is the problem number last class we solved the problem third. Now I am going to solve the problem number fourth. Okay, that is the problems on what the slider mechanism. Okay, so I already told if you want to solve this type of problem, we require the geometry box. Okay, and this what that is a what I am going to use the textbook is what the JBK does. Okay, here I am going to use some images that from the JBK does book textbook. Okay. Okay, so I will read the question. That is the fourth problem. Okay, a slider crank mechanism as shown in the diagram. This is a slider crank mechanism. The force applied to the piston is 1000 newton when the crank is at 60 degree from the top dead center, and calculate the driving torque T2, or sometimes they may ask you T1 also. Okay, so T2 is nothing but what? T1 means here they may ask you anyone, either T2, T1 or T2. Okay, so here this first step is what? If you observe the diagram first, whether the given problem is whether given in the what slider crank mechanism or four bar mechanism. Okay, if they given slider crank mechanism means follow the same procedure. Okay, four bar mechanism is that is a little different. That is there are the chance of acting the four forces on that particular element. Okay, so look at this diagram. So this is the given. So here they given this A and C points are going to fix. That is A is fixed. That is okay. And AB. So AB is given 100 mm and BC is also given 300 mm. And one external force is applying externally on the piston. That is P is equal to 1000 newton. Okay. Now so here where the fixed links, that is the fixed links will be there. You are going to name as one. Okay. And AB is the element number 2. So I wrote here 2. And BC give element number 3rd, and the piston component is 4th. Okay, so once if you note this, all the values, that is the link 1 2 3 C 4 and the AB. Okay, so now the next step is you have to assume the scale. Okay, so here the given data is only 100 300, but 100 is not possible to draw with an help of what the normal scale, but we can convert some suitable scale. Okay, so I am assumed here scale is equal to what, 1:5, that is 50. So just to divide by 50, so what are the value you are going to get from, with the help of those values you have to construct. Okay, so here the AB is given, if you divide by 50, so you are going to get what, 2 mm. Okay, if BC is equal to 300 mm is there, if you just divide you are going to get what, BC is equal to if you divide 5 you are going to get the 6 mm. Okay, so okay, 6 mm. Okay, so 1 cm, if you assume scale 1 cm is equal to 50 mm, so AB and BC will become the values 100 mm to 2 mm and 300 mm to 6 mm. Okay, once if you constructed this, okay, now you draw the crank, this what is the free body diagram of this. Okay, again next step is what, so here mark a point at any normal shape point A. Okay, so AB is equal to how much? AB is equal to 2 mm is there, and the angle is how much? 60 degrees is there. Okay, so point at point A, cut on arc at an angle of what? How much? That is 2 mm with an angle of 60 degree. Okay, so from this point you draw the dotted line, so you are going to get a line, this line. Okay, AB. So once if you got this AB, again from point B you cut one arc, how much? Here they given BC is equal to 6 mm. Okay, so here from the point A you draw an horizontal line. Okay, so here in the external, from this side a piston is applying, okay, 1000 newton, just you leave it that. Okay, from the point B to C, how much? 6 mm. Just you cut one arc, so you are going to get one intersection will be takes place here. Okay, so that point you note as what, the point C. Okay, and just join the line BC. Okay, so AB is equal to how much? 2 mm, and BC is equal to 6 mm. Okay, this AB should be inclined within how much angle? 60 degrees. This is very important. Okay, so one, and the piston force P is applying here, so here that is what, the external force is equal to P is equal to 1000 newton. Okay, so once if you constructed this, you go for the second, that is a to calculate this, how much force BC is equal to the element will be there, so how much force you are going to acting on this piston. Okay, that you need to calculate. Okay, with the help of free body diagram. Okay, so this is this diagram is taken in the previous slide only. After constructing this, you have to draw the free body diagram of this piston. Okay, so here I given piston is equal to, just you draw the free body diagram of here. Okay, so here just you draw, so one external force is applying, that is 1000 newton. Okay, next and this force is acting inclined. Okay, so keep on that scale on this element, just you drag and keep it here. Okay, should not disturb with the help of ruler scale. Okay, so that is called as F34 again, and where there is a fixed element it will be there, there will be a reaction force will be there, that you draw 90 degree. Okay, exactly to intersection point. Okay, so once if you constructed this, you go for the free body diagram. Okay, so again this also is there. So this is what BC is, what the free body diagram, but we don't know the direction where it is acting. If you want to find the direction, you need to calculate this. Okay, so this is what just BC, just to keep on scale, just to drag. So just you same here the 4 3, that is a third force, that is a element third is pushing to fourth, and this side is 2 3, two second element is pushing to third element. Okay, just you leave it. Okay, again AB is equal to just you drag this. Okay, here one force will be acting and this one force will be acting, that you need to calculate in the next slide. Okay, so okay, once if you constructed this free body diagram, go for constructing the force polygon diagram to calculate the force, how much going to acting in this direction. Okay, so here the force is given 1000 newton, so 1000 newton is also not possible to construct. Okay, again one, so again you have to assume the scale. Okay, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 centimeter is equal to 100 newton. Okay, so just you divide this 1000 divided by 100 is equal to how much you are going to get, 10 newton. Okay, so again from the scale OA you drawn. Okay, just otherwise you keep on this scale on this element, just you drag here OA is equal to, just you mark OA is equal to 10 newton. Okay, so just you draw here OA is 10. Okay, that means what, P is equal to 1000 newton forces acting on that particular element. Okay, so OA is equal to 10 newton. Again how I drawn this AB line, again keep scale on this, just you drag the line. Okay, here draw one big line, that is a dotted line. Okay, so that is what the AB is equal to 3 4. Okay, here AB is equal to 3 4. Okay, again the one force is acting on this point at the middle. Okay, that force 1 4 anta. Okay, so that force would just to draw the perpendicular line. Okay, so now you form the this triangular. Okay, so this triangle is called as what, the force polygon diagram. Okay, so what is the condition for force polygon diagram? So one, we know only the one direction. Okay, one direction, if it is this side, means the next arrow should be in the forward direction. Again the next arrow should be in the forward direction only. Okay, so this is called as force polygon diagram. So now you calculate the AB force, that is third force, 3 4 force. Okay, the third element is pushing to the link number 4 on the. Okay, so F34, that you need to calculate here, write on here, scale is equal to, you already assume F34 is equal to, how to calculate AB, this AB length into scale. So if you measure this AB, you are going to get 10.5 centimeter into 100. Okay, if you multiply this, you are going to get F34 is equal to 1050 newton. Okay, so this is what the force, how to need to calculate. Okay, so along with this, so it F34, so it is similar to 43 value, you have to take same value. Okay, that is means it is acting opposite direction. Okay, now F23, okay, this is, once you calculate this, means F23 is also same, 1050. Okay, according to the DL number principle. Okay, so now you construct this what, torque. Okay, so how to calculate this torque, again same, this is the previous diagram. Okay, this is what the previous diagram will be there, and this is the free body diagram of, that is element number third. Okay, so if you draw this again, A2, you keep scale on this, just you drag here. Okay, so you are going to get this AB link. Okay, so if upon which the one force is acting, so this BC, okay, one force is acting downward direction. Okay, keep scale on this, otherwise you need to calculate this F14 is equal to what, again here if you measure this OB, that is OB into scale, OB is equal to how much, 3, that is if you measure this OB, you are going to get 3 centimeter into 100. F14 is equal to 300 newton. Okay, so this 300 newton is acting here, this element. Okay, so here F14. Okay, so now this element again F12, that is 3 2, again keep the scale on this, just you drag the line and keep it here. Okay, so this is force acting on the third element. Okay, so what is the condition for two force member with torque? So that is equal and opposite direction, that line should be in parallel to each other, and one more is in same magnitude. Okay, so again keep scale on this, just you draw the parallel line to exactly opposite to this link number third, that is the 3 2. Okay, force 3 2. Okay, if you draw opposite to this, you are going to get one line. Okay, so with these two line, F32 and F12 should be in parallel to each other. Okay, and measure the height, and this height should be in perpendicular to this. Okay, if you measure this height, you are going to get 1.5. okay, so that you write here 1.5 into scale, you are going to assume, so that you are going to get the height is equal to 95. Okay, finally you are going to calculate the torque formula is equal to what, that is force into distance. Okay, force you already calculated, force is equal to 1050 newton into, and height is what, 95 mm. okay, so substitute here 95, so you are going to get what, 99750 newton mm. okay, again you convert this newton mm into newton meter only, divide by 1000, you are going to get 99.75 newton meter. okay, like this you have to solve the problems on the slider neck mechanism. Okay, I hope you understand this problem. Okay, just you at the last stage only you have to, you will get the confusion, don't okay. So this the F3 two force should be parallel to this line. You have to draw this. Okay, don't draw as usual. It should be what condition is there. If you want to draw this F3 two, it should be parallel to this F1 two. That is AB. Okay, and both are in opposite direction and same magnitude. Okay, then only it is possible to take the value here. Okay, otherwise not. Okay, once if you calculate this height is equal to your if you measure this 1.9 into scale, what you assume the scale. Okay, you are going to get this 1.9 into 50. Or that is why you are going to get what 95. That 95 you substitute here. You are going to get the final answer. Torque is equal to 99.75 newton meter. Okay, this much of torque is applying to stop this ladder neck mechanism. Okay, if you stop this, this is called as what the complete balance one. Okay, so I hope you understand this. Thank you.